Sankey tank, and we're following the leader, the Congress leader here, Mr. Krishna Byre Gowda, who's going to be the candidate in Bengaluru North. So thank you so much for joining. How set are you to take on BJP Sadananda Gowda?
Well, we are well set, and we have taken him on now, and we will fight to the finish, and we are hopeful that given this positive response I'm getting from public and the support I'm getting from our party cadre, we will make it through the election successfully.
Going by the last election, Sadananda Gowda was a direct beneficiary of the Modi wave. Do you think that the wave still is existent now?
So last time around, yes, there was he was a beneficiary not just of the Modi wave, but also of the division of Congress and Janata Dal vote. So this time, there is neither a Modi wave. In fact, there is an undercurrent in the working class against the failures of the Modi government on bread and butter issues. And that will work in our favor. And since JDS and Congress are also working together, it really adds great strength to our candidature.
Whereas there has been a visible rift that was seen, especially in places like Mandya, yeah, as well as other places. How do you plan to, you know, combat all of this? Won't it pose as a challenge?
No, well, there are isolated differences, no doubt. I do not deny. But in Bangalore North, from day one, there has been absolute coordination and commonality of purpose. So we are fully united in Bangalore North, and we are fighting together. So there is no issue of that. In fact, both parties are charged up to ensure victory in this election. So that's a great strength for the joint candidature.
Initially, there was speculation that Mr. Deve Gowda would be contesting from here. Later, he moves to Tumakuru, and then finally you come into the picture. Do you feel that, you know, it came as a last bit of, you know, surprise, and you've been made a scapegoat?
I do not know why you are calling me a scapegoat, because the positive response I am getting, we are assured of victory. Now, so, number one. Number two, as far as the former Prime Minister contesting, he did consider contesting from North. Due to a lot of pressure from his leaders in Tumakuru district, he opted for Tumakuru. So, in the last minute, everybody felt that since I am well known across Bangalore North, I should be the candidate, and given the time constraints they couldn't experiment with any other candidate. So I have to respect the wishes of leaders, elders and party colleagues, and general public also are very supportive.
At any point of time, did you wish that I wish I was back to being an MLA?
No, in public life you can wish any number of things, but
So that means you did wish?
No, you can wish any number of things, but that doesn't mean that every wish of yours comes true. In public life, you got to take what comes along and see what best you can do and how you can return something to the society, something positive to the society. And that's what I'm trying to do. I've been MLA for five terms. And I think it's about time that I got exposure at the national level, and if there is something I can contribute at the parliament level, I will personally benefit, and also it will be a great honor and a privilege to serve in the Indian parliament, and there are enough things to do as a member of parliament, so I don't see any disappointment in that you are seeing. I'm unable to understand your question, in fact.
Right. When it comes to the Congress manifesto, the BJP has termed it as a bunch of lies. What's your reaction?
Yeah, obviously they will say that, because 5 years ago they promised, all kinds of things. Ache then. Today, even by mistake, even by slip of tongue, the Honorable Prime Minister does not utter the word Ache then. I wonder why is it that a man who could not stop saying Ache Din 5 years ago, now cannot, even from the bottom of his memory, cannot dig out the word Ache Din. Why? Because Ache Din, the promise, evaporated.
When it also comes to the Congress, many actually say that, in fact, even Mr. Kumaraswamy has been saying that the Congress has been backstabbing the JDS.
No, Honorable Chief Minister has never said anything like that. When two parties come together, there are some differences, and we, as mature political leaders, there we understand there are bound to be differences, and as mature leaders we are trying to resolve those differences. And in fact, in Bangalore North, Kolar, Chikbalapur, Tumkur, Hassan, you name it, Chamrajnagar, we are working in good coordination. So that's the sign of mature political leadership. There will be differences. Our job is to resolve and move forward together.
You and your coalition partner have been, you know, thriving on family politics. What is your reaction?
BJP has got as many, if not more, dynastic members, so-called dynastic members, as compared to Congress. And some of the regional parties have more dynastic representation than Congress party. So I think this hypocrisy of pinning this on Congress must stop. And this selective judgment, selective amnesia, is not doing anybody any favor. If you want to talk about it, get your data about dynastic members across all political parties, then let's have a discussion on that.
Final question. One of the members here at while you were interacting has been criticizing the Congress IT cell. What is your
opinion? No, they said Modi Saab is getting away with blatant lies, and the walker's suggestion was that Congress should counter it in the social media through a strong, robust IT cell.
Thank you so much for that. That was Mr. Krishna Byre Gowda talking to us about how Bengaluru North has been responding to his candidature here, with video journalist Karthik Pratibaraman for MyNation.